So some of you have just joined now. So what we are looking at? We are looking at linear relationship. Okay. So linear relationship describe a straight line relationship between two variable x and y, and mathematically it is represented as y equal to mx minus b. Okay. And m you just know. M is just now, you can see it. Okay. And b is your intercept. How you take out the intercept? Take the x value 0, you will get the intercept, okay, and the y axis. And if you want to take out the intercept of x axis, take y equal to 0, you will take the intercept of x axis. Okay, we are only taking y intercept of y axis, okay. We can do other way around. Okay. So you will be having three possibility, because slope can be greater than or equal to net than 0. It can be positive, negative, or no slope. Similarly, intercept can be positive, negative, or start from the origin. Okay, so that is what I have noted. You have nine possibility. The first possibility I am saying that intercept is positive and your slope is positive. In macroeconomics too, you have done consumption function, Keynesian consumption function, which is non-proportional. Again, I am going to tell you why it is non-proportional. C bar plus small c y. This you people have done it. C bar is your intercept term, which is positive. Small c is your MPC, it is positive. Okay, you can take out why this is MPC. This term will be 0, then it will be small c. This is your MPC, marginal propensity to consume. Okay. So this is positive, positive. So this will be the graph of that one. Okay. Now look at the second one. Intercept is positive, but slope is equal to 0. Anyone remember the graph? Intercept is positive, but slope is 0. Investment, when your investment is autonomous, okay, you draw like this, right? Very good. Any other? In perfect competition, firms are price taker, right? You draw a graph like this also, so you will be having graph like this. Very good. Second case. Third case is that your intercept is positive but slope is negative. This one make now. This you know. Huh? Which one? This one you know. Price equal to A minus B Q. What does this represent? Demand schedule, right? Right, remember you people have done it, demand curve. So demand curve is negatively small. Here B is positive. If you take up this positive sign, then this B will be less than 0. Okay, that means M will be less than 0 and A will be intercept term, your demand curve, aggregate demand or demand. Okay, A minus BQ you have done it. When I'm taking minus sign here, that means this B term is positive. Okay, when this is positive and I see this aggregator, B is negative. B means here M. Okay, this is M. This is the equation, but I am just looking at the generality. I intercept here B, that B will be A here. Okay, or you can write like this same equation B plus MX or Q. Okay, where M is negative, slope is negative, B is your interceptor. Okay, so when will be the quantity demanded will be 0? When price is B. Okay? Say 100. When price is 100, quantity demanded will be 0, then price will be reduced, then quantity demand increases with the decrease in price. So M is negative. Now, B equal to 0, M positive. How you can draw the graph? How you can draw the graph? Yeah. Now here, when we are drawing it, okay, we can draw no grand conjunction function, C equal small c y. Okay, proportional relationship, we can draw only proportional relationship, okay. Here you have income, here you have consumption, okay. When income zero, you will get your intercept term here. As you income increase, consumption increase, but less than 45 degree. You will graph like this for this one. B equal 0 and slope is also 0. And how we do graph look like? Yeah, very good. This axis. Okay, this is your. Yeah, very good. This one will be your graph. Very good. You got it. B equal. Pardon? This one you will be using it when there are some demand function where you have to use this kind of thing, okay? Where it coincides with the x axis. You have your x, your y, okay? In this case, it coincides with the x axis. Okay, this kind of thing you will do it. Okay, there is some demand function where we can do this way also. Next is your intercept is 0 and slope is negative. How will be the graph of that? Yeah, from the origin log. But it will be proportional relationship, right? Agree? It will be proportional relationship because it is from the origin, but it is negative relationship. Okay? So I am doing on the percentage with you people, okay? So this graph you have not come across, where it is negative. Now, this is intercept is negative. Again, some people will be thinking here you have 0, here it will be minus 1, minus 2, here it will be plus 1, plus 2, okay? Here it will be plus 1, plus 2. This is y axis negative, minus 1, minus 2. Okay? Remember this part. Now, intercept is negative, it will be this side, intercept term, okay? We are only looking for y intercept, okay? So, it will be below 0. Okay, and your slope is positive. Any graph, remember, if you when intercept is negative, yeah, saving, very good. So this is a saving. So saving will be minus c bar plus 1 minus c y. We drag this one from your consumption schedule. Look at the video that I have provided. Okay, this is your saving schedule. Then your b is less than 0. And m equal to 0. Okay? How will be the graph look like? Say it is here. Okay? B is negative, say it is minus 1. And you have drawn like this. Yeah. Clear? Simple. Graph drawing is very simple. Okay? Now, b is less than 0, m is less than 0. Okay, then how it will be drawn? Say b is minus 1, which is less than 0. And slope is negative, then how it will be drawn? Like this. Right? Okay, so drawing graph is very simple. It's steeper, flatter, okay, it will depend on elasticity, you have to go through it. Okay? Whether it will be steeper or flatter, on this thing, you have to look at it. See, we have drawn all the possibility. Some of them we use in the economics. And some of them we don't use it. Okay? So, drawing graph from linear relationship is very easy. Everyone got it? Yes, no? Okay, write down linear proportion relationship. Linear proportion relationship. Okay, I take photo. You can take a screenshot of this one. What is proportional relationship? You people have done with me a lot of time. I have talked about proportional relationship. Anyone can frame the definition? From this linear relationship, y equal to mx minus b, okay, I can make linear proportion in SG. Okay, that I will be doing later on. First tell me what is linear proportion in SG. Linear proportion in SG. Okay. So if you remember, we are taking income here and saving here, okay? Saving in some proportion of income, and this proportion is constant. So saving income ratio is equal to S. Okay? So what we are saying here? We are looking at relationship between these two variables, saving and income. Yes or no? Here we are looking at saving income, and what we are saying is that the ratio of these two variables, okay, must be constant or equal, right? Which is given by your margin propensity to save. Okay. So what is linear proportional relationship? Write down linear proportional relationship or relationship between two variables. Linear proportional relationship. Linear proportional relationship. A relationship between two variables where their ratio are always equal or constant. Where their ratio are always equal or constant. Okay. So let's look at two variables. I am taking x and y for simplicity. Here you have x, here you have y. Okay. X, y. So I am looking at x, y, y ratio. Okay. Or let's look at y by ratio. 0, 0. If you remember, 0 and 0 can satisfy on the equation. Okay? If you not remember, just tell me, I will do. So 1, 4, 2, 8, 3, 2, 4, 16. Check y by y ratio, y by x ratio. What you can get? What is 0 by 0? Anyone remember? Just say yes sir, no sir. What will be 0 by 0? What happened? I am asking what will be 0 by 0? 0 divided by 0. Okay. Other also? Okay, let me remind you people, okay? Okay. So 10 divided by 5, you know how much? 2. So let me write x. Okay? For simplicity. I am a simple guy, let me write is x. Okay. So 10 divided by 0 will be some x also. Okay? That is, you people call this infinity, okay? 10 equal to 0 into x. So whatever value of x you will take, you will not get any solution. Okay? So anything divided by 0 will have no solution. Okay? I can write this as 0 divided by 0 equal to x. Okay? So 0 equal to 0 into x. So whatever value of x I will take, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0.1, it will satisfy. Okay? So let's look at this in relationship. Y divided by x 4, x divided by 2, 4, this will be 4. So I can write here 0 divided by 0, 4. It will not violate my proportion in relationship. Clear? Everyone clear? Yes, no? Okay? So proportion in relationship always start from 1. Okay? So x value is 1, y value is 4. Okay? X value is 2, y value is 8. Okay? So it will be a straight line like this. And the slope, this is average. Now you take out the slope. Okay? Delta y over delta x. Slope definition. Okay? What will be the slope here? Slope is what? Y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So y2 minus y1. 4 minus 0. 1 minus 0. Divided by 1 minus 0. How much it will be? 4. Y2 minus y1. 8 minus 4. divided by x2 minus x1, it will be 4, 4, 4. That is why we are saying that average equal to marginal. Okay? When you don't have intercept term, average equal to marginal. That is why s equal to small c by, this is average saving and this is your marginal saving, margin potential. Clear? So this is very easy to construct the jumper. Okay. So remember 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. Okay. That is what I am doing. Okay. You can do that 6 7 also. 6, 2 and 18, 24. Okay. Proportional inversion is very easy to construct. X, whatever you have in the denominator, you will change 1 unit. Okay. Depending on that, you change the Y, okay, in a proportion. If you are using the 5 table, same by 5, 10, 15, 20, okay, you can make a graph. Okay. Now coming to the part that I have to do it, okay. So this is clear to everyone? Yes, no? Okay. Now let me do one more part, okay. So y equal to mx plus b. Okay, this is a equation of a linear relationship. Okay, my question is, when this linear relationship will represent proportional relationship? When this linear relationship will represent proportional relationship? Linear proportional relationship. Anyone? When this will represent proportional relationship? When my intercept term will be 0. Right? When my intercept term will be 0, I will get a proportional relationship between y and x. Okay? Y divided by x will be m. M is constant. Can you everyone? Yes, no? So if they ask you in the mathematics paper, I don't know, you have finished it, okay? What is the difference between linear and proportional relationship? It is only this term making difference. Okay? So when b equal to 0, proportional relationship will be, your linear relationship will be represented in your proportional relationship. Okay? Now, again here, okay? Let me do it, okay? I do only one possibility, equal to 0 not. M can be greater than or equal to less than 0. Okay. Now when M, your slope proportional relationship can be greater than or equal to less than 1. Okay. Greater than 0 can be anything. Okay. It can be less than 1, equal to 1 or greater than 0. Okay. That is what I am going to do. Here you have y axis, here you have x axis. So y equal to mx represents my proportional relationship. Okay. So when this relationship, okay, y by x, okay, suppose m equal to 1. I have to consider three possibilities, let me write that. Y is 1, x is 2, y is 2, x is 3, y is 3. Okay? Or you can bump it up. You can take 2, 2, 4, 4, 6, 6. Okay? So what relationship you will get? When x value is 1, y is 1, get 1 point. Distance must be same, this much. Okay? Whatever you are taking, it must be here. Okay? Here it is difficult to draw it properly. So we need to, this much and this much must be same. 2 will be here, 3 will be here, okay? line that you will be drawing, it is a 45 degree line, if you remember. If we divide what x is equal to. Okay? So any point on this line, x value will be equal to y value. Here x value is 1, y value is also 1. At this point, x value is 2, y value is 3. At this point, suppose x value is 3, y value is 3. Similarly, x value is 4, y value is 4. In here? Yes, no. I am looking at a case where m is positive. Three possibilities for that. Okay? One possibility I am looking at here, m equal to 1. Second, I will look at m less than 1. And third, I will look at m greater than 1. This is clear to everyone? Yes, no. Then speak up, you understand. That's one. So this is a 45 degree line. Okay. Now I have to draw m less than 1. Slope is less than 1. Okay. Then what I need? Suppose x is increasing. When my x is 1, y is 0.5. X is 2, y is 1.5, this is 2. Then what will be y by x? 0.5, okay. It will be y by x 0.5. Even when you take out delta y over delta x, it will be 0.5. 0 by 0 case, you can also take 0, 0. It will be 0.5, okay. If you want to put it, you can put it. It will not make sense. So when my x value is 1, look at it properly, okay. X value is 1. Here y value is 1, I will take 0.5, okay, I will get 1.5. When my x value is 2, y value is 1, okay, this is my point. When my x value is 3, suppose here, y value will be 1.5, okay, I get this point. So I will join this point, okay, it will be below 45 degree line. Here my slope is 1, here m is less than 1. So on the line that you are drawing, make it a straight line, okay? Don't make zigzag, okay? Make it a straight line, make the point match, okay? And if you have problem, there is a video where I have drawn the graph with my hand, okay? Just look at it. So any line that you are drawing below this, okay, it will be less than 1, having slope less than 1, okay? Below 45 degree line, you will be having slope less than 1. You can check from here. So here marginal, okay, equal to average. You just look at it. Y by x is average, and here marginal also same way. Okay. Now one more graph we have to draw it. I want slope to be greater than 1. Okay. So what I will take? Let first to be 0. 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay. So y by x will be 2, 2, 2, 2. You can take it out. It will be 2. Okay. For every value of x, y value will be how much? 2. Okay. So this will be 1. And suppose here it is 2. Okay. This is 1. This is 2. Then I need 4. This is 4. Okay. So by joining that point, I will get straight line. Draw it straight. Okay. M slope is 2. I can write greater than 1. Better. Greater than 1, this is less than 1. Actually, we have taken out m equal to 0.5. Okay. This area, on this area, above 45 degree line, you will be having slope greater than 1. Okay. So, whatever thing you start from the origin, okay, when you are considering two variable, okay. And when we are looking at a ratio, when that ratio is constant, we say that we are having proportional relationship between two variables. And whenever any variable start from the origin, the relationship between any two variable, okay, you will always guess proportional relationship. Proportional relationship simply means that ratio between two variable remain constant. Okay, don't add any more thing. Okay, one is this much. Is it clear?